Good morning, y'all, and happy Monday. I wanted to get on here and just do a quick video because I see a lot of my Snapchat friends, my Facebook friends, and even my Instagram friends like going through relationship issues. And let me go ahead and put this disclaimer out here. I am not a doctor. I am only giving advice because of personal experience. And I guess the fact that you could say I'm a certified life coach and I do deal with relationships. But other than that, everything I say may not apply to everybody. And that's absolutely fine. A lot of difficulties in relationships, y'all, are two-sided. Now, I know y'all are like, I didn't do it. He did it or she did it or that's not my fault. At the end of the day, they're all two-sided. Whether we choose to realize it now or not, you will come to realize it. Oftentimes, a lot of things happen or our mate do things because of something they're not happy with us doing or they're not satisfied with or they feel the lack thereof or vice versa. That's what makes it two-sided. We have to take accountability in the things that we do to either initiate those problems, cause those problems, and we also have to take accountability in the things that we do in order to rectify those problems. Those negative cycles in the relationships come up because of miscommunication. Are conversations that weren't had in the beginning that needed to be had. There's a lot of people suffering from, you know, childhood traumas, past relationship trauma, and we bring that baggage, either knowingly or unknowingly, into our new relationships. And we miss having those specific conversations with people because either we're so in awe or we're in that infatuation stage, we're so in love, or we choose to keep it bottled in because we don't want it to affect our relationship. But at the end of the day, it ends up affecting that relationship one way or another. One thing I've grown to really respect and understand about a relationship is there's reason behind not getting involved with someone until you've resolved things in that last relationship or even things with yourself. This current relationship that I'm in, I really took my time and, you know, I was single for a minute before I jumped into it because I wanted to be right for my person. I wanted to be mentally whole for my person. I wanted to be 100% and not bring 50% effort into the relationship. And I think that's what a lot of people need to do in order to truly win in your relationship. We need to focus on improving ourselves before we try to improve our partner. I think everyone should hold themselves accountable for, you know, bettering themselves and becoming a better person before you try to hold your mate accountable for those same things, if that makes any sense. Now, I'm not saying that your partner or mate gets off easy and that they don't have to hold you accountable for anything. They do. But try sitting down first with yourself and making a list of things that you can do better in your relationship or with yourself. And vow to yourself that I'm going to hold myself accountable to getting these things done. Then go to your mate. And share these things with your person and tell your person, I'm holding myself accountable, but I need your help. Because in a relationship, we're a team. As a couple, we're a team. So at the end of the day, I can't do it all alone. Now, let me tell you where this list comes in handy. And this list is really going to help you out. We go into relationship with people all the time, expecting them to want the same things that we want. And let's just be realistic. That's not true. Everybody is entitled to their own opinion. Everybody has their own separate feelings and mindset. And what you want in your relationship, your person may not want. But we be caught in that infatuation phase that we overlook all of that. Well, now that you have this list and you know what you're working towards and you know what you're vowing to yourself and what you want, and now you're asking your mate to hold you accountable, you guys are able to communicate and talk about the things on this list to figure out if y'all are on one accord. I want y'all to remember that it's unrealistic to expect your person to automatically just know what you want and know what you need without properly communicating that. Because once again, you guys may want two separate things in the relationship. And instead of working with one another, you're actually working against each other. I'm just a firm believer and advocate in doing these things ahead of time, in those first stages of relationships, so that you're not wasting each other's time. Think about where you are now in life and your past relationships that you were in, and all the time you could have saved and avoided had y'all had some of these thorough conversations in the beginning. Had y'all really sat down and realized, nah, we're not really the same, or, you know, our goals don't align, or, you know, we don't have the same beliefs, or our morals are different. You could have saved a lot of time. I know I could have. So just have these conversations. I mean, in all honesty, it's never really too late to have the conversation. Just have it so that going forward, you don't waste any more time if you don't have to.